Hello everyone, my name is Ivan and my 3D printing project this weekend was to give the ability to my printer Creality CR-10 to print exotic filaments. When it comes to standard filaments like POA, PETG or ABS with an enclosure like the one I built, it's a terrific printer. However, lately I started experimenting with some new filaments like carbon PET, metal composites, wood, flex filaments. Those are either very tough or elastic materials. And I discovered my stock Bowden extruder was struggling to deliver constant extrusion pressure, resulting in nozzle clogs and failed prints.
So I started investigating what solutions exist to implement a direct extruder. I think the BombTech BMG extruder is the best one you can buy. It comes with a price tag of $100 and then you have to buy additionally a stepper, ideally a pancake one to keep it light, and it's another $20 to $50. The good thing is it could be mounted directly on E3D V6 content. Second comes the Titan Iron. It's an E3D product and there are a lot of good comments about it, some issues as well. The price is 108 British pounds and if you add the Titan motor it's even more expensive. What I wonder however is the final setup white enough for the CR-10?
So I will most probably end up by buying the BombTech BMG extruder because it seems kind of engineering masterpiece. However, this video is about the third option. Using stock components and some 3D printed parts to achieve an almost direct extruder that doesn't cost a dime.
So I printed two parts from Thingiverse. The first one is adapter plate that integrates the stepper just above the E3D V6 hot end and it mounts easily in the existing metal holder on CR-10. The second part is replacement for the bottom part of the extruder, the one that comes after the drive gears. And it allows better management of flex filaments. Once you print the parts, the modification takes maybe 10 minutes to install. You can see how it looks. I assumed you have E3D V6 hot end, because anyway if you want to print carbon, you should get one. If you are still printing with the stock hot end, there are some similar mods on Thingiverse you can print to get this kind of setup for the stock hot end. The Bowden tube length is less than 2 cm, which gives much better extrusion pressure.
Okay, those are some parts that I could print with the new setup. First tool, it printed very well. There are no layer artifacts, nothing, it's really great, and this is with one of the toughest filaments, the original oak filament from ICE. You can see here one failed print with the old setup. You can see I got some partial clogs and then a total clog on this level. Next comes carbon. This is very tough material and I couldn't print it before without helping manually the extruder. For small parts like this one it's okay, but if you print something big it's not okay. So here with the new setup I could print this gorgeous holder for Google Mini. This is carbon. Even some small parts like this one, this is for the central locking system of my car, the original part broke. The ultimate test, however, was this bench.
I printed it from flex at scale 130%, and then I used some pretty extreme settings in Samplify 3D for flex material, like high layer hand, the maximum that my 0.6 nozzle allows me. It's 0.4 millimeters, only one shell layer, and then I doubled the speed for flex to 40 millimeters per second. Let's see how the print goes. Maybe you wonder what is this building surface I'm using here. It is polycarbonate. I was successfully using it since 1 year. It's very cheap building surface and I think it beats many commercial ones. All materials stick to it very well, including ABS, PCABS, carbon, flex, PLA of course. It's great, and I'll be making maybe another video on this subject. So here you see some nice bridging. Okay, there is some stringing, but it's normal because I don't use retraction with flex. So the print took less than 40 minutes with these settings, and the result seems quite okay.
So when I see this extruder that is capable of supplying a lot of flex material fast, because I printed with high speed for flex, 40 millimeters per second, high layer head, I think it's good extruder. So my final thoughts are that it was useful modification. It doesn't cost anything and it does improve a lot the performance of the stack bounding extruder when it comes to flex, carbon and wood filaments. So next I'll be probably buying a pancake stepper, just to make the setup light. Anyway, I will need pancake stepper if I buy the Bontech BMG extruder. And that's it. Please give me your opinion, comment below, subscribe. Thanks for viewing.